Thank you. I want to say, Father, speak to me. Tell the Lord, Father, speak to me. Speak to me. Send your word. Speak to me, O God. Give me ears, a heart to receive, ability to perform. Thank you, Father. For in Jesus' name we pray. Heavenly Father, we say thank you. We appreciate your goodness and your kindness towards us. Thank you for our being. Thank you for creating us in your image. We are not goats. We are not dogs. We are not cats.
Thank you, Lord.
We are not family. We are not Jesus. Thank you. So wonderful, we are wonderfully and powerfully made. We belong to you. This time, Lord, let the words of my mouth and the meditations in the hearts of these your children be pleasing unto you.
Amen.
Thank you, Father. For with thanksgiving, we have received because we have asked in Jesus' name.
Amen.
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 I want to quickly ask you a question before you sit, and the answer will be found in Isaiah chapter 30, verse 15. The answer is in the book of Isaiah, chapter 30, verse 15. And you will also ask yourself, what's your slogan? Is there? What's your slogan? What a slogan means is your word, is your used word. But it means what's your strength? That's what it means. Swagger means strength. So what is swagger? In that scripture it says quietness and confidence. Quietness and confidence. Are you seeing that? I'm just like one more word. Intelligence. So when I ask you, what's your swagger? You say quietness, confidence, and intelligence. What's your swagger? Coping while waiting. Can we say it? I'll do a bit of teaching. So I would like us to have a Bible and our daughters. Praise the living Jesus. I want to take my text from Matthew chapter 1, 18 to 25. That was the encounter and the birth of our Lord and our Savior Jesus Christ. Please let me open your Bibles to you. The book of Matthew, chapter 1, 18 to 25. Now the birth of Jesus Christ was as follows. After his mother Mary was betrothed to Joseph, betrothed means they were courtship. They are not yet married. They were courting. They were not dating. There's a difference between dating and courting. Praise the living Jesus. Before they came together, she was found with the child. Before they came together, that is sex. Coming together, that means they were not sleeping. There was no sex. They were only courting. Praise the living Jesus. She was found with child of the Holy Spirit. Then Joseph, her husband, being a just man, and not wanting to make her a public example, was minded to put her away secretly. But while he thought about this things, behold, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream, saying, Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take to you Mary your wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Spirit. And she will bring forth a son, and you shall call his name Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins. So all things were done that he may be fulfilled which was spoken by the Lord through the prophet, saying, behold, the virgin shall be with child, and bear a son, and he shall call his name Emmanuel, which is interpreted God with us. Then Joseph, being aroused from sleep, did as the angel of the Lord commanded him, and took to him his wife, and did not know her till she had brought forth her firstborn son, and called his name Jesus. Hey, that story is good.
You guys don't know my
name. If you look at it closely, Sister Mary was not loose at this time. I'm sure everybody around the city or village will be able to give a testimony of who she was. And that was when Joseph was about to put her away privately, secretly. That is what ladies should be, carrying yourselves with confidence. And that's why I say, ask yourself. So I want to ask you, if you know your swagger. Yes, confidence and intelligence. Praise the Lord. What is it to cope? Coping with an act.
When you put some food into the network, good enough.
In other words, we need to contend to get by,
okay,
to make out, and to make
true.
That is when you're hoping. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, the Lord will take you away from the room of waiting. Yeah. And you are going into the room of performance and establishment. Yeah. He has done it before, he will do it again. Yeah. They did it to Sister Lia. And no matter how long, your story will be heard by everyone. Yeah. And your testimony will bring forth testimonies. Yeah. To wait is the time during which some action is being awaited. Like now, so many people have been marriageable age and are waiting. We are waiting on the Lord. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So the act of remaining in active in one place while expecting something to come that is waiting. So we should know that, and I would like to talk to us basically because of our time on two things. The first one they call things that are fundamental things. These are knowledge, these are beliefs, these are things you should know about yourself. Praise the name of Jesus. And the second one is to really talk to us. How can you cope? How can you cope? When people are mourning and they are telling you, say, you have failed. How do you feel? How has it been? When you are looking at your colleagues, they will be having children. We have classmates, they have three children. There's one thing that's basic and fundamental. Nobody can help you to bear your children. Somebody has gone through it. It's not your own. Your own is coming. In the name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. So, what are these fundamentals? They are instinctive, innate tendencies. Nobody teaches.
No, I'm on this camera now.
Nobody teaches a baby to suck breast. Joel. And nobody, these things are already there. So you wonder why some parts are called private. These are fundamentals. Any part that is private, it's not for public use. These are fundamentals. In anatomy, private parts, which are the genitals, are called private. Have you mentioned some of them? Some of the private parts. Breast. Vagina, thank you.
Armpits, good.
Penis, thank you, sir. Armpits, thank you. Your thigh. There you go. Pops. Your labia majora, your minor, all this inner parts, your pelvis, your private parts. These are fundamentals. And that's what whosoever is coming to buy. Praise the living Jesus. Your stomach. So they are your major properties. Right? It's called private part. What does it mean? It's not for public consumption. It's not for public consumption. Let's go for that. Boys and girls don't marry, do they? No. Who are those that are married? Man and woman, matured man and woman. When the Lord created him, they have named everything God created, including the woman. Did he say this again? He said it again. But the God was Eve called a woman. Eve could have made mistakes because she was not privileged to be a girl. She was never a girl. She became mature the day she was born. So it's man and woman. You may like people to ask, of course, when do you become a man? When do you become a woman? That's what we want to look at. As if you became a man and then you fought.
Angie.
Once you live with your parents, you are still in school. You are not finished your degree. You are not finished whatever you want to finish.
Hello?
Or you are learning a skill, a trade.
Hello?
Who are you?
Hello?
Hello? Who has it?
So what's up?
You are not a man. You have something to do with it. That's why I said, you are intelligence. Intelligence means chronological age or developmental age. When you act according to your age, that makes you intelligent.
Hello?
Some people are 15 and behaving like 3-year-olds.
Hello?
Hello? Yoruba people have a word, they say it and they are not doing it. That's the truth. Thinking about your age is aberration.
Hello?
It will give you a unnecessary tension, anxiety. And the Bible says, be careful for nothing. The way you act, what you imagine is behavior, is character. It's not change. Praise the living Jesus. And so that's why anytime you are born, have you won? Confidence! Have you won? With confidence. You know you are living in good living. You are a child of God. The Bible says in Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verse 1, that under the heaven there is time for everything, and verse 11. Ecclesiastes chapter 3. He says, he makes everything beautiful. Is it your time? Is it in your time? In God's time. My time is to roll in. He knows what he's doing. You are not to teach God. It's to come to be on the lead. Be like Judas Iscariot that put Jesus at the back seat.
Hello?
He put Jesus at the back seat. If you look at the next 2 days, the exposition of our Father and the Lord in the open heaven this morning was talking about your God is holy. Don't make mistakes. Marriage is a journey. It's an ever journey. It's a journey you cannot come back. It's a journey that the day you matriculate is the day you convocate and start to write exams. They don't fail that soon. So what's the worry about? There's nothing wrong in there. Passing out of the line. praise the living Jesus. So it passes out. So between the vagina and the uterus.
The video is
so it passes out. The one that you know. And that one does three major functions. Number one, the weeping of the uterus that we know as menstruation. Weeping of the uterus. Once that is mature, it shows the lady is matured. When you are menstruating, it's a sign. It's an instinctive sign that you can be a mother.
Hello, gentlemen.
And if you have sex,
I can't tell you yet.
So the second function is used for sexual intercourse. That's a vaginal hole. And the third thing, that is where babies come out from. My daughter asked me before, where does baby come out from? Is it from a bush? I see that people, they say, as someone is low, babies come out from the vagina. The third hole is the anus, and it does only one function. What's the function of the anus?
I think so I'm on your feet. I'm on your feet.
And that's why I'm sorry. For anybody to sex babies. Because very, very soon, the open there will be so weak and people will be coming without stopping. That's not the place. That space is to bring out the AIDS, the disease. So a virgin, when you say a woman is a virgin, like you have skin coming and going, that's a memory, that's a problem. That's the key you must keep. Once you release that key, you have released your confidence. You have released your pride. And I must tell you, sisters, it is not a secret to a man. It's a label to a man to say that I slept with her. But any lady that sees a man and is telling a friend, like I slept with me last night, he's his attraction. And that's why these guys play on our intelligence. A smart guy has lived with three friends. And I don't know why he saw. It's my friend. That's what we do. But they tell themselves. And the people tell God that they shall I don't want anybody to tell you, say, you are beautiful. You are beautiful is a compliment. And what is in this course? Thank you very much. I love your dimples. Thank you very much. You are so beautiful. Thank you very much. She's appreciating the creation of God. So what do you love? It doesn't mean anything. Until you have said, will you marry me? Which I talk to me. Yeah? If it is a will you marry me, it's not saying anything. I love you because God loves us. Oh, I love you. You are the only cockroach in my name. Come on. You are the only man.
So, are you doing with this son of God?
So, the key is given to whosoever you like. And why was the key? Why was there a very good assignment? It is a security check. It's to give you security. There's something I love about God. You can't receive your own. It's a security check. So it has the lock key, and that key is your hand. So it's a matter of choice. Now let's talk about the male. The major private part of the male is the testicles and the pelvis. And what do they have on the testicles is a sperm duct. It's a family of the egg donor. So there is no reason why a man is not using spirits to bring out a
It's not permitted. They are not even supposed to be
sexual. This is their logo. Look at the getting common among you. Very, very. When your nails are coming out, what do you do to it? You cut it. If you don't cut it, then you should be able to move to that. And you old. Imagine Jackie Chiu at 74. He's leaving the head. How about Ajayi? One man that is set for this. Ever allowed to be. Who gets the justice? My people, what's your swagger? Quietness, intelligence. God bless you. Praise the living Jesus. So, please have a thought. There's nothing to this. Very obedient. He has a direction. And the direction when he's standing straight, he has a purpose. All you need to do is keep it in check. Go back in the body, God likes you. He's looking for where to put it. That's not the time to preach to. There is no morality below the belt. No morality. It's about the school age. It's once you are alone and you realize the practice is talking, it means knowledge is passing. It's just like a madness. Madness has a field. Love also has a field. Only validity is something. It could be the way you are dressing. Maybe you are dressed in such a way that half of your breast is out. You may say, I'm like, there are certain things because they are old, they are fundamental. It's the name of Jesus, you remember me and you. Because Jesus Christ said it in Matthew 19, that some people are born, you know, and some people are born,
talking and racing.
you are sometimes even feeling sexy. So what drives you? Do you now masturbate? Do you now get a guy? Then that's the book of Leviticus. I think chapter 18:22 forbids man sleeping with man and forbids woman sleeping with woman. Why? Because of Genesis chapter 1, verse 28. The first lesson is that we should very soon there will be extinction. The married man will marry you. No, you go to extinction. Because they can produce more children. And that's not the will of God. If anyone works against the will of God, it's not going to break that individual. God is trying to supervise the destruction of that individual. And that will not notice. And when you are crying on masturbation, the thought of sin is sin. That's why you are caught there. You can't do it. So how do you know? Number one, you must believe every word of God. Every word of God you must believe this, from Genesis to Revelation. Psalm 119, verse 105 says, it's God that to my man, believe as last. What does it say? Like what? It's a lamb. It's a lamb to my feet and a light unto my path. If you believe the word, it will work for you. And I said to you, every one of us, in Isaiah chapter 34, verse 16, that you will never lack in grace. Then me, oh God, I have done what in thy and what in me. How do you connect? How? It's not God that will do that for you. How do you connect your own? How do I connect my own? God will help you in that way. What God will do, you can't do it. What you will do, God will not come and do it for you. You won't miss your own. And in the mighty name of Jesus, you don't marry your enemy. Yeah. You never go to the wrong room. Yeah. In the name of Jesus. Yeah. Believe every word of God. Let it break you. When God said, jokes, jokes, the mother of Jesus told the disciples, whatever he asked me to do, do it. Do it. Number two, get busy. That's all. Say, get busy.
Get busy.
Get busy for me. Get busy in the church. If you are a youth and you are not a rocker, you are not really so. When are you going to do it? When you say you are married, there's a lot of responsibility only one on you. Even as a mother, as a wife, you are good, you are done this. This sex will lack up for now. You will be running away from it. That last one is. We'll be talking inside our children's room, pretending to our husbands as if they are Christian. That my wife, they are not. Mumbo. You see? Something you will do and get tired of it. Sometimes a man should be tired and go on holidays and go to a hotel and say, hey, it's a weekend. Because he knows the individual of the wife is at. So let's get tired of it. So there's nothing to rush about. Get busy for the Lord. Don't waste time. Don't move with time wasters. Don't talk away if like. There's a word in Psalm 40 verse, I think 10, 46, 10. What does it say? Stand still and know that I am the Lord. If you will check, that's hoping. Wait for him. Don't leave him coming. Don't allow distress or the pressure of anybody. Because the man just in that verse says, I know the thought I think towards you. It's not God.
Good.
Oh, not evil. Even if you are 30, 40, no worry. It is for you to have the best. It's for you not to go into an error. It's for your life not to be stressful. It's for your life to be glorious. It's for your money to be an example to others. It's for your money to have an onion that will bless the church. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
God can never forget you.
Yes.
I'd like to see a church, maybe you tell me, that has more programs than the Deep Christian Church of God. You know, most of you don't even attend those programs. You prefer attending programs where people have charisma without character. I don't know how a church will be teaching and giving this beautiful name to sing. is Aristo? What's Aristo? Big men, and small girls. Small boys going after big girls. That's Aristo. And they have that without apology, because I have a lot of youths that have come. I said, Pastor, I said, what they do? They masturbate. And they preach it that it's not bad. It is far, far, far. Not only that, it is wicked. And the Bible says in Leviticus, the land is cursed in the poverty shedding him. As you are supposed to bring blessing to the land, what's a curse? What is part of it? There's a lot of program in the game. I think that we have with the national programs, regional programs, commission programs, solar programs, area programs. It's a if you know, I have to write a letter. In my parish, we have vision. And as a zonal pastor, I should be there. I have to write, and I brought my provincial pastor. I have to write a letter. Can you imagine? Before we were there, we were not here, we were there. We have a lot of problems. I tell them, every program carries blessing. I tell them, get busy. Looking at options to practice as a case. There will be a lot of things to do because you will live long.
Amen.
Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Number three, mind your associates. Best of your feather fall together with your friend. Keep an association for all good manners. You need the right people. You need the right team. And I don't like this when they are asking me, mommy, can we marry a Muslim? Will let take my day? A bird wanted to marry fish, you know what I mean? And I'm prepared. What's the letter? When the habitation leaves, what are you doing? If you marry a Muslim as a lady, where are you? A Muslim, automatically. A Muslim. Except you don't know what I'm doing. You must live on in faith. You must live together in faith. He was a Muslim like me, and he's now born again. Yes, he's talking, but you must have entered the church. And you know that's a spirit field. How do you know? Yes. If you are living in holy life, you know. Because I must raise that night. Praise the living Jesus. Any guy that loves you, he waits. But everyone that says, I must speak with you and test you, testing. Like before, we all have to go and eat. Many people will taste you. You want to marry, you know, when you get to the bridge, you cross it. And nobody will teach you this kind of sex. Because you want to know him, you know me. You have to find it out yourself. It's a school that is only God that can take you to. And I know that we never end your day. You are very fine. By the time you are husband and wife, they like to say, you have been with together, you no longer need. Ashamed, almost every man becomes open to this of you. Then you begin to search, where is it that you make you aroused? You will get it, you can tell me, because I'm no longer ashamed. But when you are doing this, shame will come, even when you don't want it. Struggle will come, fight will come, cost will come. And I'm going to say, I should come over to you, where the goes. The man said, no, it's not that he does not like you. For somebody has been trained, a guy has been told, will you overtake what someone is? A guy. No! They are training the guy. Will that guy move soon? No. Well, I'm not afraid. God bless you. So I know you don't know you. What do you think he says? Then you stop telling him.
Yeah.
Then we train him. My father did not have him. Okay, it was the man in the future. So what's the next thing? We tell lies. Now check Proverbs 20 verse 6. A faithful man. Who can open up our room? If you allow them to tell you lies, they will tell you lies. If you like the truth, you will tell you the truth. You know it's a spirit. You are asking to lie your black hair. Then we get the money. Then we get the money. I'm looking at him, I'm looking at him. there will be his projects. If I see opening, I say, first grade, whatever grade, is still opening, I will not lie. But today, if you send a dress for 100,000, I will buy. That's the truth. There's time for everything. You can't be a student and also be a mother and be a worker for a job. You are simply confused and disordered. That's confusion. What you are doing, just face it, praise the living Jesus. So it is sex. We open you to emotional problems, physical problems, spiritual problems, as complete separation from God. So don't do it. You are a lady, you are still in school, and you have somebody that wants to marry you, you can marry so many ladies, because a man was a man. The Bible says that the man shall be four times or on the store. God is not a talker. The man shall is a man that's living. He's a man physically, spiritually, socially, financially, you are standing. Even if it's a room, a stove, and one pot. But to have an income is good. And that's what I want to advise you. If your wedding ceremony is the only condition you have, you cannot make a good home. Before you can have a big wedding ceremony, there was somewhere to cover. You train yourself. You went to a bad time. And you ask someone, what is your big pass? You didn't have my let your parents. You know, parents are always happy. When you want to marry, let them commit the money. You make the money. When my first son was to marry, yes, he had to see a lot of money damage. We spent a lot of money, Pastor. First year, this one won't come this year. It just came up. Only about to marry, she didn't even get me to marry. Only one of them is still in the world. I must say, how much did you have? Did you cost them that you want 20,000? You okay? Can we have a list? Oh, no, no, sure. Come in, thank God, I've been able to make it on the dog or in there. All the lists. This box, what do you make? Clothes, bowls, every item that I put belong to the bride, they said, please can you get them? So that's in the bag. I was always ready and love to watch. Have you done this? No, I didn't get it. What's it going on? As I leave the house, as I stay between the two families, we will do that. So when you come to watch, the assets of the days, and I said, whichever days you are giving to us, we give us the days. Let's see, sir. I must say, so that they were not happy. He thought I was going to buy a very big car. I just told my husband, how much is the car going for? And I have to say, we like, I wish you pass it over. So, as they were planning, no, yeah, they will have to get a car to cover us. I will have to let them be really passing the car. Or we'll go there. So we brought the down, put the seats. My son told us, you are not my parents. You don't need to attend. You only need to know. All of them know. You know. You know. In the human. Sweetheart, no babies. I did this thing. So they have the answer there. No problems. It was so low key. In fact, all the persons I was, I already went there. It's just. In the way you went, I don't know. You know, too shy, you know, that. You see, my God was to do for them, the first one was peace.
To us.
Oh, baby, it's not going to work for you. I said, oh! I don't want to see you. I said, I'm going to go to the manager. Amen. Let's begin now. Number four. Avoid petting, nagging, stroking, kissing. Deal with your sexual appetite. And how can you deal with it? Through prayers. It's controlled by the woman. Just tell the woman, no pleasure was in mind. You need to pray. Don't succumb to pressure, the pressure from parents. Some parents do worry their children to marry. Don't succumb. Mommy, don't worry. God's time is the best. I just want to be sure that God is leading me. Friends, my friends are married, I need to marry. Don't compare yourself. The Bible says, compare yourself with yourself. Don't compare yourself with another person. And whoever is doing that is of Christ. It's like saying it's a fool. Don't compare yourself. My wife is a man. Have you not seen your mates and that head? Hey, my wife is you. Those are mates. Those are that head have mates. There's no man in the jungle. Sleep your own. They sleep my own. No noise making. But what's their life? No mates. You are your own mates. So just tell Jesus what he wants. He will do it. As his time. Number six. Not by God's revelation, not the revelation of our time. What's the revelation of our time? Is he educated? Does he have a car? Who are the parents? What is the social class? In that back in here. You know what you want? Those are revelations of our time. And in practice, I have masters. There's no better. It's something that I don't want to learn.
I want to switch to
you.
I want to
switch to you. The revelation of God.
Now, so take a good shot.
And by sending it to you, you don't like it, don't pray. And you have to pray out. Ladies don't pick others.
I'm on your camera, right?
That's what I'm doing. But do the man get home with you, like, the lady, you see me. You know, if the lady, my girl. Among those that are coming, it's like a flower at some body. So many insects you go to places. You know, I'm a man. You can't walk yourself into a man. If you are the one marrying the man, you will run after the man saying, ah, oh, my people, my master. But if he's the one that I will run to you, oh, like a word, such men in the chance. He will love you till you die. There are no love. That's why God says, husbands love your wife. He didn't say why he's love your wife. Because there's no together
in one day.
After marriage, the love of the man will go down.
So just pan with your own camera.
But because you are no longer marketing, if somebody tells me now, mommy, I see Bishop, God says I should marry you. I'll go for the winners. There must be something wrong. Where are you? Where are you? Who will deceive Bishop? See who?
My camera.
That's the truth. When you are married, that's one thing we do, sisters, today. There's no difference between your dressing as a lady and as a woman. That's your prepared. And that's why your babies are not fine together. You don't even have a proper. So that we know how to pack these babies very well. The impact you see is an individual. When a child is very old, you put him there and he sweats. When he's there, when he's hot and he sweats, you put him there.
You put him there.
Old. That's God. That's what is at the back. God did not create anything useless. Everything has created. Have you heard him? Please put your hands together for the Lord. That's God. So we have to be prepared. So don't succumb. Walk with the revelation. Proverbs 19 verse 2. And whatever God has given to you will not break it. There will be no struggling. There will be nothing to struggle in love there. Then before you say yes, think. And guys, don't tell any woman. Holy Spirit says you are my wife. Will you wrong here? Which Holy Spirit says that?
I want to take that shot.
A very strong feeling and conviction that you are my wife. That's better. Can you say, God, I'm sorry, when you go, God will never say. And very soon, you don't like my character. God will not say it to me. It's not the liar.
I'm out of it.
If you are telling me, I'm beginning to worship, that worship is better than that marriage. It's possible we are going to worship and go to the river. It's possible. Maybe not a worship because you're looking for CDM and you're not going to go to the river. That's the truth. That's the time to learn. That's the time to have a king. That's the time to know yourself. That's what's never done in the secret. Bring it to the knowledge of the church management. And the pastor with the law. So that there will be no confusion in the church. Once you break up, you break up. And nobody will be happy because there's no sex. Oh, I just want to be interested in this one. It's not worship.
Short right now.
That's why worship does not mean you'll be forced. But like worship, you don't enjoy it and you are doing it to the demanding of a human. You need to bring it up and you discuss it. And there's one thing. Don't lie to yourselves. There are so many guys, because their mother has said marry, they want to travel. That's God wants. But the mommy says, ah, for too long. You know, hey, I won't continue. Is that possible? And they will now move you, marry a lady without saying anything. Because my get pregnant, I should have wait to try to not worry. In the next 2 years, I will bring you. That's a wrong commitment. That is weakness of the next to that. You know you are traveling. Immediately after marriage, you are two. You are no longer two. How many are you? You can't think of you. If she's not going with you, you stay. That's the truth. So don't let people in the church have you be it. You know you receive time, let her know. I'm going with her. As you are going, you go. You are going to have to you to provide them with your own money. Because there's no shout hallelujah. So, why not for with one another, be open with yourselves and get committed to training. So listen, get committed to training, get committed. Whatever you are doing, be the best. It's education you want, get to the climax. You want to just have a little bit of education for you. Bring that to clients, go for training. Add a bit of skill and be useful. It's wrong for a man to just be there doing nothing. The woman is doing one for him, or the man is doing one for him. God bless you in the name of Jesus. And finally, grace marriages don't happen by law. They don't happen by accident. They don't happen by chance. Mommy and Daddy Gio did not happen by accident. I'm sure Mommy Gio believed that he was marrying a potential BC.
Yeah, hold it for a while.
Do you know that Daddy Joe had been jailed? And they are trying to make Joe marry him. Because those days, pastors don't have money. But that is somebody said that they are a pastor. Over the issue, he never. So it's a journey. It's a journey that is not to stop telling the process. But the end is it. Say amen. In a being like this, I live. But the end is sweet. After which, if you continue to be sweet, you will be blessed with glorious children. You have peace of mind. In the name of Jesus. So it's a lot of prayers. It's a lot of obedience to the word of God. Obey the word of God. Occupy your life in the church. And shall you all be in Jesus' name. Shall you have peace? Heavenly Father, we thank you. And then we bless your name. But there is no like you, of a truth in God, and genuinely you are God. Thank you for this, your children, thank you for speaking to us. We ask, O Lord, our God, in your infinite mercy, every error we have committed, we pray that is right and keep all by the blood of Jesus. And we open a brand new leaf, we are going into the world, we are going into life again, and that starts afresh with us. Testimonies. Use our lives, use our us to talk to others. Thank you, Father. For in Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen.
bless you. I pray that the Lord will affect that which concerns her. Everything that's already affected, the enemies will not have a say over it. In the name of Jesus. And nothing will go wrong with her. Nothing will go wrong with her family. Nothing will go wrong with all that pertains to her.
Ask Banji to mount his camera now. That camera is pastor you
know. And that she will not be seen on the last day. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name we are praying.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
God bless you, please be seated. Now I explain to us, we'll soon just step out of here for the wedding that's going to take place. So we'll go to our next venue, which is I think just about 5 minutes to walk. Just 5 minutes to walk towards the left. The king is coming. So the sisters will take the main auditorium. The brothers are going to the
children's
auditorium.
That's first. Okay.
Please, I'll give you some information later because we will not mind if some of you can tweet at us. But the number of times I have something to ask. And please, this is my choice. It is not to say if somebody told you that once I was blind, this business, what do I do?
Okay.
So when you ask that way, he gives the other person the way to know I'm not the only one. So then I listen.
What do you want?
Very early in ministry. So I can see the
what
essence
of this. What do you mean?
There are times to go to places and people are very
short. The
streets are where they are not warm at all. Travel to Europe every distance. When I finish ministry,
this
pastor, God bless you. What a wonderful Europe that you have with us today.
The bottle
of water
is
not
available right now.
And I'm not saying now that in case somebody said that's why you are hearing that from me.
Take me off.
Those who hear me speak, they know. No. Say it as it is. I was angry. And this, something like this will have to really be careful of. Because I saw something in the Bible which can help you. The Bible says that if you enter any house and they do not receive you well, and I've said to my family, those I've pastored before know that whenever we have a guest in the house, personally we must also try and so we see into the life of that guest. Personally also, we must do that because the Bible says that when you leave that place, your blessings leave with you. So that's why I'm telling you that people do 7 days program, you know, 5 days program, and you look as if you get a finish. You can't really dig your hand on anything again. So I'm saying that for the benefit of those of you that will be useful to you. I was angry because I had to buy black market for them. Then I had to pray on my faith that Jesus said their testimony. I just told God, I said, Lord, you know I'm a covenant, I will never be stranded. God said, just drive on. I kept driving until I got home and everything went off. I went to attend a meeting in one of the, you know, another pastors in the ministry. And the senior pastor there came out and he said, something South Africa, and this thing happened. He said, I was angry. I said, thank God. I was sure the way. Because I thought I was Ghana. And he taught me something. He said, God asked him, son, why are you angry? He said, you don't say, look like I'm angry. Now this is not fair. That not even the bottle of water. Not ever I said, God asked him. He said, why you not the one who says the laborer is worthy of his wage? He said, what's the last year?
Who is the
laborer? He said, this is a prayer. Who employs you? Okay. Come and minister. Go there. Minister goes to what we join. And I move. Why? Because somebody shared his own story. And I was able to benefit from it. So if you want to ask a question, let's just give room to about few people. We can take two brothers, two sisters, before we go to the other sessions, because our other two speakers are in the house. We have with us this morning Pastor Mrs. Noka Adeshiba. And like I said to you that our approach is going to be different. When we go there, we are breaking into human agenda. So the first person that will speak to you is somebody of the opposite gender. So, if a man can tell you something about them, believe him. What led to that? When I was a student pastor, I looked into my congregation and I saw that the skirts of my sisters were getting shorter. And you know there are some armless that are harmful. Very harmful. I said, God, how do I pass message across to them? I just came on the altar one day and I said, every good looking sister, apart from just getting good looking for herself, of course she's also trusting that somebody will marry her. Everybody said yes. I said, brothers, what's your idea about these skimpy skins and whatever? And the brothers were all shit. The best fellowship they some scared green. Because when the people you are actually targeting said, you be sold, everyone behaved. I liked that many years ago. So you'll be hearing, the sisters will be hearing from a man, the brothers will be hearing from a woman. Do I have two, three persons? Is if you want to leave to the right, well, can you please stand? And please come forward here. Yes, please bring the mic. Okay. Any other person? If at this age you are ashamed to ask questions, then it's not okay. So if you have a question, get up, come there. And in case you still want to write, and the usher will take it from you. All right, we have a question there already. Sister, what is it?
There was a time I made in Ghana. I was only mentioning something about the kindness and the feelings. And this guy was so much on me that I won't see my bones. But he tried for like 3 months and I don't even have any feelings for him. So I have to meet one of my pastors and I told that this is what I'm feeling. The woman said I should pray, do this, and I did everything, but it wasn't just work. He said maybe I should just try and look at what. Is there anything that I like about him? But I don't know what to do. I can't even pay my debts or anything that I owe about him. So at the end of the day, I have to tell you that, brother, I'm sorry.
Please to God, that is not you.
And since today,
nothing.
So I wanted to ask if, is it that I'm still repaid or something?
Thank you for that question.
I should not ask a question. This is
Peter's
question.
No, it's Peter. You're just some sister. You don't like anything.
I'm sorry, I believe
you. You're not like, you see some sister. You don't like anything about them. It's very possible. Yeah. Not even that. Same thing. Maybe to lock to them.
I will beat you about
so you will see
the children of Israel
had not left the
Jews. Because that he can't go again, that he has gotten another person quiet and
humble. What's the thing I did?
A year later, I went back to him to beg because I can't sleep. Think well. Eat. She was going nuts. I called him and begged for why she was begging, sex or God. So today, she is not herself. Because I think we should be able to pay this system. Till then, I am not myself. I see him in my dreams. I think only about
him. I can hear you.
After the sex, he said,
I can hear you.
I can't hear you.
I'm
sorry. Can you help me out? I think we just get to you. Please, if you like, don't go with all the questions in your bring them forward. And the grace of God, the one that cannot be answered will collect them. That's why we have all your details, the Facebook and all that. We will get the answers back to us. That's why God has brought all of us together. Yes, ma'am.
Okay, that's a good one.
Thank you very much. The best one is stopping the animals. You know, that's interesting. You remember the same thing that you have. It's the one that you like. Not only that comes to you. If it does not come to you,
move to his place. Move to our place.
Keep
off. Take
it. Yes, so you don't force yourself into the relationship that you feel
switch.
That's
switch what you do.
Or that.
Yeah. Play in the video now.
You must be sure what is helping you. Like I said, if you are working on the relation of our time, it will be very difficult to get
the
contract. He wants full paid money. He has a car,
he
graduates, has a house. Like that. If he has sufficient, he will be
saved. He's functionless.
Mommy and daddy, Joe, married to the young. I married my husband, one husband, 2 years ago, we had only one room. I had a CD, and today I have paid with him. So, you can continue to grow. As long as the man can make some strong room, that was what we had when we used to see. This one is fire. This place is the room.
Fred,
by the special grace of God, God has increased us. He also increased you.
Fred, and I'll teach it. We'll disturb you.
And the one beautiful thing is that God is not small. The woman has mouth. If you are married a man that has 10, 14 hearts, you must not go there. If you go there, it's good to marry a promising, well, good, future-looking man. A man that is serious. I don't marry a man who is completely and solely depending on the parents' wealth when you control that woman. You must be sure the man has friends of his own, because the Bible says that the man shall be. So, depending on what you want, depending on your structure, I think the structure of a man is simple, a woman is simple, a God-fearing man, serious, dedicated, and with plans. Then you pray together and you work it out. But they are thinking of somebody that is well made alone. So many other people will like that man. And you may need some other help to get it. The
long courtship. I don't require a long courtship. 5 years is much. Too much. You know that. That's why your mind is still there. So many people have seen you together. I don't like the end. The courtship is too long. And that's why sisters, I don't like working with girls. I don't like working with girls because they release secrets. I don't suffer for it. Once you know, what people are already in the room. God, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. And the Holy Spirit has said everybody. I told you, the best and worst causes are men. They cause it, and they can say anything. Things that you keep as secrets, never a secret to a man. When they speak with you, they are making a point. Because you will need a psychiatrist to tell your friend over this one. Once you tell your friend, somebody is sleeping with you, what will be a problem? Are you a prostitute? It's not something with Jesus. And that's why they play on the intelligence, and that's what I said. 5 years worship is too long. It's dangerous. Once you are not ready for marriage, keep your relation and keep her right. That's dating. Once you want to start worship, tell the pastor to let your parents together. They won't kill you. Then it is wrong for a sister to go and greet a brother. When we say these things in the church, we think we are too. And then, there's a way our own parents in law, they tell us, why they're not only here for 1 point. That's what they say. And so, it makes us so antisocial. I was not going to dream. But these days, ladies are so big and sit on the man's side, rubbish. Nonsense. What's this right now? That's it. When a man has decided to sleep with you, you can walk. Walk out of his life, out of the door. What's the best? Nobody. And before the man could mention that she, this is not a virgin. If you are a virgin, you can also. In here, only go to the virgin. You are only hungry for me. Simple. There's one thing you think about Jesus. He takes back impacts like that. Just forgive yourself. That's the first thing. Forgive yourself. And open a brand new life. A brand new life. With every method of you. So you'll be content with that problem forever. That man doesn't like you. Ladies don't run after me. Don't marry the one you really like that sister. So I'm going to start again. Ah! Oh, my boy, oh, man. Don't have it. Don't. And you give them the box. 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 That's how we run after you to be that. On the one that you are begging, John, you continue to beg him. And you continue to misbehave. After that, you will leave the job for you. Because it's the church that will be constraining you. So please, I beg you. Don't push it. It's not good. It's not really good. Highest, maybe 1 year. And that means you go into a relationship where you are really mature and ready. Thank you. Thanks.
That's very auspicious. That's deep. When we talk about, I have a question. I want to ask those who are grouped around that time to ask my question. And I'm happy that this week somebody brought up that question with me. I've seen something correct into this side of the world, and it is proposing between. Usually have proposals from men that are either
not fully educated, or not working, or not spiritually sound like me. In short, many lesser than me in all areas. The ones a bit okay usually say I'm too religious. Please advise me.
Amen. It's still the same thing. It's still the same answer. If you are fully occupied for the Lord, there's an aspect of caution now that I think civilization is taking away. That's the third holy party.
You both are picking up back. You're not picking back in another graduate. Both of you are picking up back.
I think to some extent it was. Because it worked then, it has to work now, and it will not work all the time. Elijah was a top holy person. He went on a journey, very long journey, to bring Rebecca and he prayed to God. That's why your character must be very good.
You saw them with him.
It's possible, and you see you.
That guy.
And I've seen it. And something will tell me, really, I can declare a meeting and arrange you. I won't tell you, I won't tell you. I'm just declare, and you will meet. It's possible. That's why your character must be good at all times. You can't compare yourself with your husband. In fact, you can never be the same. Why you are an helpmate? You are not a weakling. The woman must be strong. Focus that you want to marry them. That does not mean you will marry a lazy man no more. If it's next in trade, if he needs to go to school, you can tell you. If you like it, I will not be able to go for a person. There's only thing that choice has to be said. She has masters, but she was married to a nuclear. But today the nuclear is doing the nuclear. She told me, and I know in my morning, when I'm sure of the question, and I called her, is that only I have sisters that are already doing the nuclear? So I had to join them. And I decided to learn it. It's been helping me. It's a nuclear, let go, complete plan. You know, when you go to school, that's where we can call you a civil engineer. Yes. Education makes you a civil engineer. Education, without education, who are you? A believer. Or today, it's almost 3 million people. And they're married with the child. And they're happy. When you see this brother, you see the commitment. Who will like him? Who will be a woman? What has Master spent with the money? So, who you are does not matter. God can make that man. And I'm very, very sure. It's after the marriage that I realized this guy was handsome. So, my genuinely, what's the point? Come on, see, would you fair lady? And because the lady ought to have this type of leg. You understand? Money, fact, money, that one. So, you are not good. Allow God to finish.
It's a question we have to praise the Lord.
I won't have spoken at all. When the mother is speaking, you've got to remove your heart. My second time with my mommy, and two things with me. Number one, what she has presented to us today is too simple. Anyone who will not hear it is not only there tonight. Please keep it. If you didn't hear it, go back to it. We will push you up to buy all the tips. That's the way we will push you up, buy all the tips, whatever tips she has in. So that's one. Two, I don't want to drop a line. The second question, that's why this what she or my mom said something which then makes for secrecy is the power of sin. Constant. During that we said you complain about his character. If what you wrote was exact, you know that anything wrong. But was there any purpose higher than you that was a no in that
relationship. Because that is your pastor now, you don't sound, pastor, you don't understand. My pastor is not like that. There is no person in church, mature above all of you, that understands what feeling and emotions are like. If you're too young, that knows about this relationship. To whom people have said, I've been telling him about this and he's not listening. When you walk the way, where was that passage that you have walked back to? That was your home. I always wonder about your home, the new children in the market. Your father just tell her. So she knows those phone calls, even when you didn't tell her that it's the phone call. Secrecy is the power of sin. Take all the advice and God will restructure you. Give you a better story. God bless you, man.
Hallelujah. And this is also today. One of my sons came to Russia recently and he said, Pastor, I have started the church week and the lecture. So when the sister continued with me, she said, Brother, she didn't move out. I report you to Pastor David. And she said, before she come and report, let me report myself. Please, pray for me. I said, I don't need to waste my prayer. Sit down here. And I told him, do this, do this, do this. Secrecy, your heart is a part of sin. It takes a bad man to want to harass you in the open. But when the two are behind a closed door, there will be no dignity to do with them. It is well. Let's please start as we just pray. We need to run this. Please take this instruction. If you are not registered, please ensure you do. And as we walk out of that place, you know, it's not far at all. You know, the big kilo car, you know, good for them. We should just carry them who are gone. And I think very likely those who are driving will be able to move very fast. I want you to just say, Father, I thank you for this session. Thank you for what I have. Thank you for that vision that I see there in my life. Thank you for the blessing that you use to bless me. Thank you, Father. Let's send me the name of the Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. God bless you. Please, we're moving to the parish. The King is coming. If you move out, you turn to your left. Turn to the next, and when you get to the next church, just take a rest. Exactly, as the king is coming. Please make sure you don't leave anything behind.